So I had a great question from a mom who said, like, I don't really get even what an online book club is. Like, you're just going to tell my child to read so many pages and then they show up and then you're like, okay, what do you think of those chapters? So it's more than that. I thought I might give you a little glimpse into how we're going to be starting on Thursday, July 7th. And what I think is really great about this course that I've created for this summer. I do a book unit every summer, but I never think to actually produce it in such a way that it could benefit a homeschooling mom later to teach her own book club or do a novel study unit. So let me use some of my 30 years of teaching experience and share with you how I would, in this case, start our book club. So, we're going to be reading a book called Maniac McGee. It's been around for 30 years. I guess it was kind of like just hitting it when I was starting teaching. That's interesting. I didn't even make that correlation. But it has so many great, important themes, serious issues. You know, I don't dumb things down for kids. Kids can handle talking about some tough things like what is homelessness? How do people get into that situation of being homeless? And so it's such a great opportunity to lead to great discussion. So we're going to start. And one of the first things that I'm going to do is explain to the students that when we do a book study or a novel unit, whatever you want to call it, an online book club, I always do my novel units with the into, through, and beyond approach. Have you heard of this before? It's a teaching technique that's used to prepare students ahead of time, during, and after a unit study. And this is something you can use anytime that you're studying something. So let's say that you're going to be learning about photosynthesis and you're grabbing your science book. You may still want to do some into activities before you go through the study and wrap up with some good beyond activities. Now, this could be super simple, I suppose, if somebody said, okay, so here's our into. We're going to be learning about a book by Jerry Spinelli called Maniac McGee. That would be a very short into, in my opinion, because I think you have a great opportunity here to dive deeper. But that could be your into. Through could be reading and discussing the chapters. Beyond could be a quiz or a test, I suppose, that you could give at the end of a book. It's not how I would do an into, through, and beyond because honestly, that would bore me as an adult. So I can only imagine how boring that would be as a student. So, what we're going to be doing is we're going to learn about the author, Jerry Spinelli. We're going to learn a little bit about the backstory, why he wrote it, where this story even originated, what was his inspiration, etc., and the location as well, because the story does take place in the state of Pennsylvania. So, there's lots we can do there. So, for instance, I'm going to give them several fun facts about the author. I think it's really important that when you read a novel, you take the time as the teacher to do your homework. I didn't know all of this about Jerry Spinelli. I went to school first and learned about him before I taught the course, right? That's what we do as teachers. You learn it first, you collect a ton of information, you weed out what's interesting versus eh. You get rid of things, you look for more information until it's what you feel would interest your young learners. So, this is one of the really fun facts I think about Jerry Spinelli. He's still alive today, by the way. He's in his 80s, but he wrote this book when he was in his 50s. And when he started to write this book, he really struggled with finding the character's voice. So, Maniac McGee is our protagonist. His real name is Jeffrey Lionel McGee. And he really wanted this strong voice because he is the protagonist. He's like the hero of the story. Yet, Jerry Spinelli was really careful about not wanting to make him sound too grand or like the hero of all heroes. So he got 80 pages in on his first draft and he decided, nope, this is not going the way that I want it. And he hand wrote all of his pages. 80 pages, my friends. He tossed them in the trash. He went back to it. He tried again. He made it to 100 pages on his second attempt, but guess what? He didn't like it. Still, it wasn't right. He tossed all 100 pages. Okay, he waited. He took a break. And finally, he landed on what he said were the 9 words that changed everything. And you can see them here on my slide in the bottom right-hand corner. They say Maniac McGee was born in a dump. And that was it. He was like, that's it. That's where I want this story to start. Humble beginnings. I want my protagonist to be humble. And it's a legendary character, and we'll talk all about that, tall tales and all that good stuff. But that's the first line of this book, and it took him a really long time to get there. And I think that's encouraging for young writers to understand. Now, in our course, I'm going to give a couple other fun facts too, but for just the sake of this short video, I just wanted to give you a little idea of what does into look like. So I'm still in the into stage, and I'm going to talk about Pennsylvania. So Pennsylvania is one of our 50 states. In fact, it was the second state in the 13 colonies. We're going to take a look at this map. I love maps. Do you love maps? I love maps. And we're going to take a look at where it's located. And this is a great opportunity in the into. You know, I'm just not the kind of teacher that wants to constantly talk at the students when I have live opportunities. I like to ask them questions too. So I hope you're doing that in your home as well. Like, hey, let's write down all the states that border Pennsylvania. And notice I put PA. This is, again, a great opportunity to say, did you know that every state in the United States has a postal abbreviation that our mail carriers expect you to use rather than write out or type out an entire state's name? PA are the initials for Pennsylvania. So see how you can like just tie little things in like that. So without like anybody looking, if I were doing this at home with my boys when they were younger, I'd be like, okay, grab a piece of paper. I'm going to do it too. I always like to play. And I'll be like, I'm going to see if I can name all the states. So you just look at this picture here, right? All the states that border the perimeter. Oh, yes, my friend, here a little math terminology go in there. Border the state of Pennsylvania. So again, such a great opportunity here. Are they going to say Ohio? They should. Or are they going to go, is Columbus what this state is? Like, again, such a great opportunity for geography. Yes, we've got West Virginia here. Looks like Maryland, New Jersey. New York is over here, right? We've got New York is over here, right? So you all write down what the states are that border Pennsylvania. It's just, again, a great opportunity. When students go into a book like this, before they start to read, they're already invested. They're interested. They want to know some more things. And I'll be telling them some more things. Again, I'm not going to go into all of that right now, but I will say my next slide is all about chocolate. Oh, yes. We'll be talking about where the character lived, how far that was from Hershey, Pennsylvania. I mean, seriously, Pennsylvania is the state that's state food is the chocolate chip cookie. So it's a winner right there. Okay. I hope that inspires somebody. I'm thinking of just putting this together and giving this slide presentation to any homeschoolers looking for something like this just to do on your own. And if that interests you, let me know. I'm happy to share that with you, and then you can make of it what you like. Okay, maybe I'll add it to my Teachers Pay Teacher School, Teachers Pay Teachers account. Maybe that's where this should go. What do you think? I'd love to know. All right, I'm here to help, and I'm excited for the book club. If you are watching this in real time, our book club live virtual Summer Book Club starts July 7th, 2022. Are you in time to make it? I'd love for your kids to join. Right on.